If you want to understand neurofeedback and want some help making sense of all the different devices out there on the market, this video is for you. So as you probably already know, it is a booming industry with brain training systems, neurofeedback devices. It can be very overwhelming between the headbands and the apps, and then there are the professional systems, and you're trying to figure out what actually works and what is really the right system for me. So I'm going to walk you through the different types of home neurofeedback systems available today, what's effective for long-term change, what's better for temporary boosts, and how to choose the right tool for you and your brain, and taking into account your budget. So neurofeedback, just to briefly explain it, it's a type of brain training. It's a non-invasive, and it works by measuring your brain's electrical activity, your brain waves, and feeding that information back to you in real time. And that feedback might be a sound, it might be a visual shift, and it lets your brain know when it's moved out of balance. And the result, over time, your brain learns to self-correct and function more efficiently. But how that feedback is delivered and what kind of change it supports varies a lot depending on the type of system that you're using. So if you're looking for lasting transformation, so that's better sleep, emotional regulation, sharper thinking, then probably a professional grade neurofeedback system is where you want to start. These systems were originally designed for clinicians to use and have been adapted for home settings. And there are two main types. There's protocol-based systems like BrainPaint, Nerva, that begin with a brain mapper, QEG. This is a static image of the brain's electrical activity, and a clinician uses this to set protocols designated to shift your brain towards healthier brainwave patterns. So during a session, you might watch a screen or listen to audio, and that change is based on your brain's behavior, and it's conditioned to function at its best. So then there is dynamical neurofeedback. Right now, NeurOptimal is the only system on the market. It takes a very different approach. It doesn't use a diagnosis or protocols. Instead, it monitors your brain activity in real time and gives your brain feedback exactly when it senses instability. And then your brain can self-correct because it knows the difference between what it's doing that's maladaptive and what's in the present moment and appropriate for the here and now. So protocol system is really gearing your brain towards a change. So to summarize the main differences, protocol systems steer the brain towards the goal, and dynamical systems show the brain what it's doing and let that brain self-adjust. Both aim to create real lasting change, but the mechanism is very different. Now let's talk about consumer grade headbands like Muse, Mendi, Narbis. These are app connected devices, typically under $600, and they're designed for short-term support. They work in two main ways: entrainment, which is to get your brain to resonate with an external rhythm like a light pulse or binaural beats, nudging you into a calmer, more focused brainwave state. Operant conditioning, like dimming a screen or flashing lights to signal when your attention drifts so you can learn to refocus. These tools can be really great for momentary relaxation or productivity, but they're not designed to create lasting neuroplastic change. So once you stop using the device, your brain usually returns to its baseline normal habitual patterns. So everything we've talked about so far gives the brain feedback, but it doesn't add anything into the system. So now let's look at the growing category of neurostimulation headbands, which do the opposite. These devices stimulate the brain using small electrical currents. The most common form are the tDCS, or transcranial direct current stimulation, and CES, the cranial electrotherapy stimulation. You'll see this device like Flow Neuroscience, Lifted, and the Fisher-Wallace stimulator. They're often marketed for things like depression, anxiety, and cognitive enhancement. These tools don't give the brain feedback. Instead, they attempt to push the brain into different states by applying a small current to specific regions. It's still non-invasive in the medical sense, but in contrast to feedback systems, this adds something to your brain rather than training it to shift on its own. If you go this route, it's essential to talk with a healthcare provider first. Okay, so now let's talk about price, because this is where many people get stuck, understandably. Consumer-grade headbands like Muse or Mendi, they cost between $250 and $600. Neurostimulation devices range from $500 to $1,000. These are simpler devices with limited computing power, and their effects are shorter term. Professional-grade systems like NeurOptimal, BrainPaint, Minerva, they range from $7,500 to over $10,000 to purchase. But here's the good news. You don't have to buy one to get the benefits. You can also rent a professional-grade system like NeurOptimal for about $650 to $900 a month, depending on how many sessions you plan to do and how many family members. Renting gives you full access to the system's power without the upfront cost of ownership. And the truth is, your brain is the most sophisticated technology you own. So a $300 simple headband isn't going to deliver the same kind of results as a system built with advanced amplifiers, EEG processing, and clinical grade sensors, etc. So with brain training, you kind of get what you pay for. So which system is right for you? Well, it's good to ask yourself, do I want to feel calmer and more focused right now? Or do I want to retrain my brain and how my brain functions overall and over time? If it's the first, then a headband device or stimulation device might be helpful. If it's the second, you probably want to look at professional grade neurofeedback, the systems that are designed to teach the brain how to regulate itself long after the system is over. And certainly renting is a great way to try it without a big financial commitment. So to recap, consumer headbands are great for momentary shifts. Neurostimulation headbands attempt to change the brain state with a small electrical impulse, and then professional grade neurofeedback systems train your brain to shift itself and function differently over time, and that leads to the real transformation. So thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, please like it and subscribe. Drop your questions in the comments. I'd love to hear from you, and I'd love to be able to answer any questions.